I'm to ask you, and I don't know if I'm going to set this up properly, but about a mascot. Is it the Islander mascot? Is there a story regarding a mascot in you?
Yes, and it's a very famous story. And we're allowed to swear on here because there has to be some swear words.
Nobody's
that
watching.
Come with
yeah.
it. Okay. Yeah. All right. Yeah. So I get drafted by the Islanders in 91. I get to the Islanders organization. My head coach in the minors is Butch Goring. The head coach at the NHL level is Al Arbor. The goaltender coach for the organization is Billy Smith. And, you know, obviously the reputation precedes himself. Like there's this grizzled, like tough as nails goalie coach. And everything about Smitty was like percentages. So you stand here and 7 out of 10 will hit you. Don't ever let them come around your crease. You make sure, you know, like he had all these little things, and it was kind of, you know, it was intimidating, but it really helped me because he was all about mental preparation. He's like, the game is up here. If you think it, and if you're ahead of them, you'll be able to handle everything. So I'll never forget. I'll cut this part and make it short, but I got sent to the East Coast League for the weekend. And there was 5 goalies in the system, and they had 3 at the NHL level because Mark Fitzpatrick had a rare illness that when he would get sick, he would get sent to the minors so he could recover. And that would bump me to the East Coast League. So I would go down for the weekend, I would play. And what happened is Glenn Healy ended up hurting his finger, and I get called up from the East Coast League to the NHL. I stay there for the night, and they finally, because they got to fill a void, they send me to the AHL. And I get out to the Rock. It's Toronto's team. I think it's like St. John's. Oh. St. John's.
St. John's.
St. John's.
Yeah. St. John's.
St. John's Maple Leaf. So I get out there, and we're playing on a Tuesday and Thursday. So I go and join the team. And Butch Goring's the coach. Billy Smith is the goalie coach. So I get out there, and I start the Tuesday game. So I go skating out, and I know Smitty's there, and I want to impress. And as I go to scrape my crease, there is like this bird of a mascot. His name was Buddy the Puffin. It's like this weird shaped like bird. And he's like doing this hex and like kind of like skating towards me. And I'm like, all right, I'm just trying to like focus for the game. So I'm scraping my crease, and he would come near the crease, and I would like push him out of the way. And it was just weird. He was being annoying. So that first period, I like stand on my head. I'm like feeling really good. After the first period, I go into the dressing room. I come out for the second period, and the bird is in the crease, like standing in my crease, like doing a hex. And I got to skate like the whole, the second period, you got to skate all the way down. So I skate down. I give him a push. He pushes me back. And I'm like, this is weird. But the crowd's kind of getting into it, and I'm scraping my crease. I didn't even think anything about it. So end up having really good period. Third period comes out. He's there again. I push him. He kind of pushes me back. And I stand in my head. I don't know the score. I think James Duthie ended up looking it up. But like in my head, I think we won like 3-1 or 5-2 or something. And I got like a star. And I made like 35 saves, and I was like unbelievable that night. And I am so proud. I'm like, hey, I just put a show on in front of my goalie coach. And so I come off, I'm the last guy off because I was a star. And I go into the room, and the guy's like, hey, Noodles, you know, and I go to, and in my stall is Billy Smith. And he's like, I need to talk to you in the hallway right now. And I was like, all right, you know, and I'm thinking, oh, he doesn't want to give me all the accolades in front of everyone. He takes me out in the hallway, and I'm standing there, and he's like, don't you ever let that fucking bird stand in your crease again. And I was like, what? Like, I just got first star. And he's like, if that fucking bird's there on Thursday, he's like, you take him out. And I'm like, what? Like, and honest to God, I'm not lying. Like, it's a Tuesday night. I didn't sleep a wink that night. He's like tore a strip off of me, and we practiced the next day. And all I keep thinking about is like, what am I going to do with this bird? Like, you know, and
yeah.
And I'm hoping like, okay, maybe I'm not going to start Thursday because, you know, maybe I'll start the other guy. So as he's skating around before practice, I'm looking out of the corner of my eye and I'm watching Butch Goring and I'm trying to avoid him because I'm waiting for him to skate up and go like, oh, I'm going to start the other guy. He skates up to me, he goes, Noodles, you're playing tomorrow. And I'm like, oh my God. Like, and I'm not even thinking about the game. I'm thinking about this stupid bird. So I'm not, I swear to God, next game. So Thursday comes, game. I get out there for the first period, like the bird is kind of like, you know, hexing me. I'm like all locked in. They score like 4 goals in the first period. And it's, I'm just brutal. Like I should get pulled. They should pull me. I swear to God, I think my mind, Billy Smith told Butchie to keep me in to see how I had handled this bird. So after the first period, I come out and the bird is in my crease giving me the hex. And I was like, fuck this. So I take off 200 feet and I run the bird out of my, like I literally hit him as hard as I could. And this bird goes flying into the corner and the crowd goes crazy. And I don't know if there's a 14-year-old girl in there. Oh, there's an 85-year-old man. Like I have no idea who this bird is. And I bury this bird and the crowd is on me. I think we lost like 7-1 that night and they left me in and the crowd was giving it to me. And I was just rattled the whole night. I come after the game and Smitty's in my stall with a smile on his face. And I'm like, yeah, sorry. He takes me out in the hallway. And he's like, that's how you be a man in this league. And I'm like, oh my God, I just gave up a touchdown. I literally just gave up a touchdown. And he was like, you show them how you can be. And I was like, unbelievable. Like that. I'll never forget that. But like to this day, people from St. John still send me notes going like this Buddy the Puffin is like their mascot out there. Like it's, you know, that's the guy or whatever.
That's one of the best stories. I'm not just saying that, by the way, especially like on ice. And that is a testament to what it's like, especially then, like, well, you're like, that was over 10 years before I got to the A. But I feel like in the American League, it was such an important thing. Like our coaching staff, I can still remember Gary Agnew and a couple guys that were coaching us in Syracuse. And we had a team full of like WWE guys. Like it was a shit show. And it's all they fucking cared about was just like the sideshow stuff, the fights, the hits. Like it was such a priority over everything else. And it was like living in the twilight zone. So hearing that just resonates with me. I totally understand it. That's awesome.
Yeah. I was, I'll never forget it. Smitty was like, the smile on his face, it was like a proud father. I was like, all right, well, I'm like, just so I can remind you, I just gave up a touchdown, like seven goals. Yeah. So anyways, it was kind of funny because and years later, I love Billy Smith. He was so good. I had him for the first 2 years, I think, of my career. And he was just so, he was good for me on the mental aspect, being a pro, how to treat people, how to approach the game, how serious he needed to take it. There were so many lessons I learned from him, but like, I don't know if I take a lesson that night. I just more think it's a funny story, you know?